instrument is a hybrid instrument in the nature that country B characterizes that instrument as a debt, whereas country A characterizes that instrument as an equity under its laws. Therefore, when B pays interest to A, B will get a tax break on that interest, whereas A will treat it as a dividend, and normally this dividend could be exempt from tax under the participation exemption regime, especially in Europe. So this is again one of the advantages of investing through hybrid instruments, but which has again caught the attention of OECD, and OECD has heavily come down on this, to say that in a case like this, either company B should deny the deduction of interest, or at least company A should then levy tax on such an income if company B has allowed deduction on such interest. Let me quickly touch upon the last aspect of what I would like to discuss today, and that is the concept of tax effective migration of an entity to a different jurisdiction. So take a case where an entity has made investments into India, say for example from Dubai. While Dubai is an ideal jurisdiction for making investments because there are no taxes paid in Dubai, but from an Indian perspective, Dubai is not an ideal jurisdiction because the entity in Dubai wants to have a higher stake of the Indian entity to end up paying capital gains tax in India. And therefore, there is a promoter who feels that I have already invested from Dubai into India. How do I migrate my shareholding from India to a tax efficient jurisdiction like either Mauritius or Singapore as the case? Now, there are various modes of migration. One option could be Dubai could just give the shares of India to an entity in Mauritius, in which case one could argue that in case of gift of shares, the exemption under section 47 applies as far as the transferor is concerned, so there cannot be any tax liability in matter of transferor. And we have several advanced rulings on this aspect. So that what we call as contributing the shares of India to the Mauritian entity. But that poses the question, what about the taxability of this income in the hands of the Mauritian entity under section 56? Because if Mauritius want to receive shares of an Indian company without paying any consideration for it, obviously section 56 would get triggered and the book value of shares would then get taxed in Mauritius. The advantage here being that under the India-Mauritius tax treaty, one can take recourse to the other income article, and under the other income article, such an income would not be liable to tax in India. So this is one effective way of migrating a shareholding from a non-treaty country to a treaty country. The one more effective way, I don't think too many people have explored this option, but certainly an option worth considering is what we call as re-domiciliation. What we mean by that is, we merely change the domicile or the address, if I may say, or place of incorporation of that entity to the new jurisdiction. So I mean, taking the same example, the entity in UAE, I just re-domicile it to Mauritius. Thereby, it is the same legal entity which has merely changed its address, so to say. So there is no transfer of business from one entity to another entity. There is no question of any capital gains tax. I have merely changed my domicile from country A to country B. This is something which has not yet been tested, but we look at this closely and we do believe that it is indeed possible to migrate jurisdiction, especially if you see lots of US companies which have been set up in the state of Delaware. They have migrated their entities to tax efficient jurisdictions like Mauritius in the past under the re-domiciliation rule in a tax effective manner. So if you were to do that migration, there arguably there should be no tax implications which arise on such re-domiciliation. Care, of course, needs to be taken regarding the mode of such re-domiciliation. It should not be so evident from the documents that the company in UAE, in our example, has been liquidated and a new company has been formed in Mauritius. So then it would not amount to re-domiciliation. The paperwork should be crystal clear to show that the company is merely changing its domicile from country A to country B. It is not a case of company A getting liquidated and company B getting working on the country. That's a very interesting concept worth looking at. There are a host of other issues which I have captured this slide, but I think we have already run out of time. So I would like to end my presentation out here. Maybe we could have a few quick questions if there are any. Keeping in mind that I am only a standby batsman for today's session, if you would kindly spare me and not throw any bouncers, that would be lovely. Thank you for your patience.
नहीं एक और मतलब बेसिक देवर सेइंग कि हमारे मार्शल स्पीक की स्पीक से कंटिन्यू की है जरूर टेक द ब्रेक आल्सो आई थिंक यू हैव प्रूव्ड दैट एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट राजेश टू गिव अ हार्टी वोट ऑफ थैंक्स
E20 special investment will not need time to prepare or